I have to constantly remind myself, like, healing is not like a straight line. It's more of like a squiggle. Okay, just start talking.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, I'm Kat Circo, and I'm here to tell you what it's like to participate in a clinical trial. What is a clinical trial? A clinical trial is when they are trying to study if a drug or a treatment plan is effective or not. In this situation, it was trying to add an extra layer of care for curing cancer. How did you find out you had cancer? I had just been experiencing some weird symptoms, and here and there they were insignificant, but then I honestly just had a weird moment in a Monday meeting, and I got so dizzy, and I just felt off, and I just had this instinct that something was probably wrong. And so I actually left as soon as that meeting was over and went to the ER, and that's where we ended up doing an ultrasound and taking some biopsies, and a few days later I found out that it was cancer. What led you to hearing about the clinical trial, and how did you get involved with the clinical trial? I heard about it because after my first round of tests, my scans came back, and the cancer that I had spread into some of my lymph nodes. And so part of the clinical trial was having that in your lymph nodes, and that qualified me. And so after the scans, that's when UCSD Health came to me and, you know, gave me the rundown and invited me to participate. Tell us about the clinical trial you participated in. I probably should know, like, the name of the trial, but I don't. It's kind of a lot of information to take in at once, but basically the clinical trial I participated in was testing if this additional type of chemo or immunotherapy was effective in the timing of administering the drug. How long did it take to start the clinical trial? So I think it was probably maybe at least a month after I got the news and decided to participate. And that was a little nerve-wracking for me because my tumor was growing, like, really fast. Between the first initial scan and the second scan, 2 weeks in between, and my tumor had grown, like, a centimeter in diameter, and so it was, like, the size of a lemon, and that really freaked me out. What are the pros of doing a clinical trial? The people, you get extra people. You get a whole extra layer of care. So I have, you know, my main oncologist, my radiation oncologist, and the clinical trial coordinator. And they are amazing people. They help schedule things for you. I hate calling people on the phone. And I didn't have to because they were doing that. They were calling and scheduling a lot of these things for me, which was such a huge relief. And they're great. They chit-chat with you. They care about you. They have great insight from other patients. That's just a different layer than that comes from your doctor. So it was just really interesting and really amazing to feel this just whole extra layer of care and support every single time. I think that I would have really missed that if I hadn't done the clinical trial. What are the cons of doing a clinical trial? Cons, I don't really have a con, actually, to explain here. I feel like I had a really great experience, and I felt very informed, and, they were very upfront with so many things. So I don't really see, actually, any cons in my situation to speak to, which I think is nice. Did the clinical trial work? Well, I don't have cancer right now. So probably, yes. I think that it's still in the works right now. I would love to understand if I'm ever going to personally see the results. I think that would be really cool. Were you worried that you would get the placebo? This was probably the most common question I got about participating in a clinical trial. And I did ask this question, what's up with the placebo? And the answer is there was no placebo. Placebos are only really used when they're trying to find out if a drug is effective. That's where that placebo and those control groups come in. This was not trying to figure out if it worked or not. It was trying to figure out when to give it. So that's what the two tiers of the trial were. It was like the A was 3 weeks before my chemo and radiation, and B was starting on chemo and radiation. And so that's the arm that I got into. So that was something I just didn't really have to think about, is like I was just not going to get the placebo because it just wasn't needed. What makes working with UC San Diego Health doctors special? I was blown away by the doctors and the care and their memories, because, you know, they have so many patients. They have all of these things. They just come in with a smile on their face. They're there. They're ready to cheer you on. If you're not feeling well, they're not happy. They want you to be feeling better. So you just feel like you are the center of attention, to be honest. And it's really great. I would also have moments where I would, for instance, like send a message to Dr. McHale, and then Dr. Mayadev would call me and say, hey, I saw this message. Just wanted to follow up with you myself. I know Dr. McHale's on it, but just wanted to do like a double check. Like, let me know what's going on. So just like those really small like layers and moments, I was always so blown away that they had time to like think about me that way. So it was really amazing. Who in your life supported you, and what did they do to help? I am so lucky. I have so many people from all aspects of my life that showed up, whether it was just support on social media or coworkers or people, you know, showing up and, you know, offering to walk my dog, which was needed because I have a crazy border collie. But I also decided to be very open. And because I, you know, chose and was able to be really open and honest, I got all of that like love and support back. So this was gifted to me by my coworker. This is a giant blanket of my dog. This is my dog, Ava. She's a border collie. I love her so much. And this made my day. So this was actually my chemo blanket. My chemo situation, I loved it. I would go in and I would ask for 3 pillows, one under my knees, one on my lap, and one behind my head. And then I would ask for 2 heated blankets. And then I would put this on top of it. So that was like my kind of chemo situation. And it like really made for a great laugh, because the nurses would kind of like turn around the corner and then like see this giant face and become a little startled. And we would just laugh about it and have a conversation. And, you know, it's just one of those moments of having something around you that just makes you happy. So what would you tell someone considering to be in a clinical trial? I would say, you know, just get as much information as possible. Ask a lot of questions. No question is too dumb or stupid. It's so important to just be as informed as possible. I've had a lot of ups and downs emotionally, physically. I have to constantly remind myself, like, healing is not like a straight line. It's more of like a squiggle. So that's something I have to constantly be telling myself on days where I'm suddenly feeling bad and I'm like, why? This is so frustrating. You have to be really patient with yourself, but it's also really cool. You know, it's so sucky to have cancer, but at least in my situation, I was able to do something positive with it, and it's going to lead to like this knowledge share. And I think that's a really, really cool part of it.